This program was funded by First State Financial, Ashland. Thank you for your support.
This Urban League was created, started about 1968. Chapter was established. We became a part of the local United Way, and the first executive director was hired. His name was Walter Brown. I volunteered to help him as he was getting started. That summer, I worked for the Community Action Agency, and that fall, Mr. Brown asked if I would want to come work for the Urban League, and I did, and you know, the rest is history. Here we are with about 47 years or so later.
The housing concept started back in 1981 when they formed the Development Corporation. It was formed to promote economic development in Fayette County for the low and minority neighborhoods. Then from there it progressed from there. We provided housing for seniors. We have three developments, and more recently was the Russell School project over there on 5th Street in Toner. Poverty in Fayette County is often a hidden factor, particularly because of the affluence of Fayette County. You have pockets of poverty that are unseen or hidden. Families that are living in substandard housing, paying more than 50% of their income towards rent and living expenses, high utility bills, and they're really struggling trying to make a life for themselves. And the children are exposed and suffering, and therein comes our mission, is to bring in quality, safe, and housing that is not only convenient, but is also affordable to them.
Well, I lived in an apartment, and I was actually looking for a house. My daughter actually found this house online, and when I came to view the house and discovered it was an Urban League house, I had never rented from Urban League, and that's how I got into the program. It's a benefit for me because I'm not able to own a home right now. I've actually sat on the porch and I've had people go up and down the street and say, I've worked on that house, I did this in that house. And I'm like, well, thank you. You know, but they told me that they came in and they gutted some of it and that some is an addition, and it's really a nice house. It's a nice house.
There's an abundance of abandoned and dilapidated properties in our target area.
When you come upon several houses that are run down, the windows are broken, and some of them have even been set on fire, the yard is not kept. And regardless of the neighbors, the other houses around it can be nice houses, but that one house is just an eyesore. And it's like you're not really taking care of your area. And everyone wants to live in a nice place, regardless of where it's at.
So removal of blight is essential for someone's outlook, someone's attitude, someone's motivation in life.
There's also something that's contagious when we go into a neighborhood and start to make the changes. Then you start to see other neighbors do things to spruce up their properties. Do things to maintain it better. There's all kind of growth, all kinds of development.
Well, it would certainly leave a void if there was no Urban League and if there was no housing, affordable housing. You would have families that would not be able to find decent and affordable housing. Where do they go? Do they have an alternative? The seniors, can I live with my children? Nobody, they don't want to be dependent, they lack independence, so where do they go? I don't have an answer.
Well, this particular program wasn't here. I don't think that a lot of the houses that they have worked on would have been anything done to them. I think that the houses would still be run down. You know, a lot of people, the areas, people wouldn't have homes to live in, affordable homes to live in. So For me, I think that this program has opened up a door for you to have a better way of life, a better way of living.
Quality of life is affected. Crime goes up. Families become dysfunctional. The burden to take care of that population grows. You know, that's a scary thought. I can get in my car and I can go and drive down the street where I know we've made a difference. And I can see kids playing in the yard, someone sitting on the front porch. And we know we had something to do with that.
Because when you go through the neighborhood and you see the houses that are done, and then you realize that it is an Urban League house, you're like, there's another one, they did another one. You know, they're working on another one. And it's a good thing. It makes you feel good to know that you are a part of it.
So yeah, we do transform neighborhoods. That is our purpose, not only to have a transformational impact on neighborhoods and to not only to provide housing, but to have transformational impact.